Hello and welcome to the semifinals of the Madison, Wisconsin Regional Championship. You saw Kyle Sukovic defeat Kevin Baxter last round, and now you're seeing Kyle Sukovic once again play his good friend and co-worker slash partner over at the Top Cut. We're into turn two. It looks like Ben went first, missed the energy drop, retreated to a Sigalith, and passed the turn back. Ben is playing Rizzian Genesect with Roserade, and Kyle, as you saw last game, is just playing Evil Tall Garbodor with Trubbit. With Darkrai.
Keep us posted in the chat on how the stream's looking. We are having a knockdown, drag out brawl with this internet, trying to get everything working, but we're doing the best we can at the moment.
Don't know what we're talking about.
Obviously, if you're watching the recording, just ignore this. So Ben, it is Kyle's turn right now. He just played it in.
Ben went first.
Opened with that Sigalith. Missed an attachment, which is super gross. If he gets one on his next turn, then it's just as bad as if he had gone second. But missing the turn one attachment with Frizzing Genesect is one of the worst things that can happen.
Definitely.
He opened Sigalith, which I didn't even know he played until that happened.
He actually opened the Virizion and retreated Sigalith.
Fair enough.
Either way, he had it in his opening hand.
Shouts to William Compere, introducing the concept of Safeguard in a Virizion Genesect deck.
It looks like Kyle does have the energy. I thought Kyle passed the energy as well. And Ben missing energy there really can't be overstated. The Virizion Genesect deck is so good because you don't need many resources on turn one or two. You just attach and get the Emerald Slash on turn two. And if Kyle has any kind of pressure here, he can really start to do a number on Ben. I think that I think that Sigalith there, the Safeguard Sigalith, is going to go a long way toward slowing Kyle down here, and that's why Ben retreated into it. You know, he just really wanted he knew that missing the energy drop on turn one was not where he wanted to be, and having that Sigalith there is going to slow Kyle down a lot, you know, make it so that Kyle needs to find his complete catcher.
Kyle does not play a catcher. I can't imagine he does. We've seen a game or two of Swiss and a full best of three in Top Cut, so I strongly... he's hiding it really well if he does. I even like watched him on a deck search, and I was like keeping my eye out for certain cards, and I definitely didn't see any catcher, so I think it's pretty safe to assume he just doesn't play the card.
He does have a lot of outs to the Safeguarders, though. He has the non-EX Evil Tall. He has Buffon. If you really
he has Garbodor. It's a pretty good out to Safeguard.
Garbodor, and then probably...
Deal's going to be on Ryan eventually.
Yeah.
That's like, I tried to watch this training.
Yeah, so we see a professor's letter from Ben. So he is at least going to get an Emerald Slash this turn. So essentially in a position where he missed out on the big advantage of going first.
He basically just skipped his turn.
Yeah.
Skipped his first turn, yeah. Also, as I was saying about the outs to Safeguard, really, Garbodor is Kyle's best out, as it just completely shuts down Safeguard. But also, the more classic out, I think, is definitely Hypnotoxic Laser with Sableye. Just being able to play a laser, buy it back, play a laser, buy it back. Just becomes very, 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 very good against the Safeguard decks. And Ben finds a level ball. Looks like he's going to switch out his Roselia. What do you think of the Roselia, Mike?
I love it. Seems like Virizion Genesect is kind of the point where a lot of these lists are within like 50 to 55 cards of each other, and then your stage one choice ends up being really big. Like the two Virizion Genesects that are in top four, Ben is playing a 2-2 Roserade, and my boy Dustin is playing a 2-2 Raichu. I played against the Virizion Genesect playing like a 2-2 Drifblim line today, so it seems like your stage one choice ends up being really big here. Ben chose to neglect the Raichu, which was probably the second most popular choice for sheer consistency.
Drifblim was a big one a few weeks ago.
Yeah. For sure. I think Drifblim, people were just kind of afraid to play it because if you guess wrong, you just have worthless cards in so many games.
Yeah, Drifblim's really only good against Plasma and other decks that run Long Switch Energy.
Exactly.
Like in this top eight, for instance, there's not really all that many. It's really only good against Plasma. You really don't want to be playing Drifblims versus just like this Virizion Genesect deck that does run four.
And I think Raichu's superior anyway because it gives you, it's so good against Lugia, which is the only card in Plasma that gives you trouble. You don't need a Thunderous counter. You don't need a Genesect counter. You just need a Lugia counter. And Raichu serves that purpose, as well as countering Yveltal, as well as just doing 100 to anything, which is pretty strong. So I think Roserade and Raichu are the only two real choices here. I was talking to Ben in between rounds earlier, and he was just laughing about how, quote, I can do anything whenever I want. Like, he just, Roserade is just incredibly powerful. Like, so, especially in a deck like Genesect, where you do just kind of need one card every turn. Like, you need the one energy switch so you hit your G booster twice in a row. You need the, like, whatever. So, the one muscle band so you can red signal up a Blastoise and kill it.
For those of you who don't know, Roserade's ability lets you search your deck for any one card when it comes into play.
Yeah. Correct. So that's a super good effect. I'm not sure if Ben plays a 1-1 or a 2-2. I'm assuming a 2-2. I think that's generally the most common. But he also plays at Sigilyph, so maybe he didn't have room for the 1-1 either in his deck list or on his bench. He might just not have space to dedicate the two Roserades.
Very, very possible.
So this matchup inherently, like historically, has been relatively favorable for the Genesect player, just like Darkrai Garbodor versus Virizion Genesect. I feel like being able to G-booster Darkrai has always just been really good, but now that we've got like such a cheap attacker in Yveltal, that partnered with Kyle being able to actually use lasers thanks to Garbotoxin could possibly make it a little more positive for Darkrai Garbodor. Do you have any input on that? Do you think anyone just has an inherent advantage matchup-wise?
I think... I know that... When you and I were playing these decks, we played Spear Tomb in our Yveltal decks, because I think that it is very, very difficult for a deck like Yveltal that's kind of building up a bunch of Pokemon to really beat a G booster. It can be very difficult for, you know, if you... Obviously, Yveltal does have the Y Cyclone attack, so you are trying to kind of play around that and spread your energy out and make it so that one knockout on Ben's side isn't devastating for you, but it can be very difficult to do. That being said, I do think that the Garbodor is pretty strong versus, I mean, it shuts down Roserade entirely if that happens. Shuts down Red Signal, which can be important. And more than anything, I think what's happening now is kind of the weakness of Garbodor in the deck, where Ben is going to take these kind of free turns of just attacking, knocking out a Trubbish, putting energy onto his Pokemon, just kind of building up his board so that he can get into a position where he can just G-booster twice for game and just kind of string attacks along, which is really just exactly where you want to be.
For sure.
In a match like this, but I'm not really sure who's actually favorite. I guess if I had to put on one side, I'd say probably Ben's, but I'm not actually entirely sure.
Ben, did he target down that Trubbish, or is it just stuck active?
He attached and red-signaled
it. I noticed someone in the chat asked why, and I think the big reason for that is not only to take a prize with Emerald Slash, which is just really strong, if you're going to, like, Emerald Slash, the 50 damage helps a lot of math in a lot of different situations, but it's 80% for getting energy out of your deck. If it did 20 damage or if it did 30 damage, I think it would still be pretty good. So being able to take a prize with Emerald Slash, it's kind of like taking a prize while junk hunting. Like, it's just something that's sort of rare and generally really strong. And also, Garbodor, like, lasers give your deck so much trouble. Like, 170 is such a good number for Darkrai Yveltal to hit. For them to be able to hit it against you, thanks to Garbotoxin letting them use lasers, poses a pretty big threat. So I think if Trubbish were any other 70 HP basic, like if Kyle were playing something silly like a Roserade or some other just evolving basic, Ben might not have prioritized targeting it down, but being able to take a prize with Emerald Slash partnered with being able to possibly slow down Kyle getting a Garbodor out. Just kidding, there it is. Anyway... Either way, I think there were two small pros that added up to it was worth the red signal. I think one or the other might not have been enough to justify it, but the fact that he's targeting down a Trubbish as well as taking a prize with Emerald Slash definitely warranted it.
And the other thing, too, is that there's the Enhanced Hammer from Kyle, which won't play too big of a role, but we'll be able to slow Ben down a little bit. I think a big thing, too, is that Virizion Genesect is a very powerful deck, but it's very powerful because of a few things working out. So when you don't have red signal active, for instance, it can be pretty difficult to win because you rely so much on that late game Shadow Triad for Plasma, red signal, a killer thing that has ice spread damage to with Virizion and kind of
For sure.
There's like, I love Virizion Genesect, I think it's a very good deck, but there are kind of a very few things such as getting energy on turn one, having red system lines, there's just a few things that you have to kind of consistently do to be able to seal up the game. And there's the third energy on the Genesect DX from Ben. Looks like he was getting ready to reach. Maybe? I see a muscle band in his hand. Does Ben play Hypnotoxic Laser?
No.
Yeah, okay. I wouldn't assume.
I am fairly certain most losing Genesect decks have abandoned.
Yeah, yeah. Especially when you have to run like the stage one lines we've been seeing.
For sure. I think G Booster is pretty good just in general. And that's sort of why they've abandoned the lasers, because 230 doesn't matter. You'd rather just G Booster as many times as possible in a game. But what's interesting is that he doesn't really have a way to hit a number like 130, which is relatively common.
Definitely.
And he doesn't necessarily want a G Booster for one prize either.
Yeah, you really can't afford a G Booster for one prize. It's very similar to the exchange of Black Ballisting against like a Flareon deck or one of the Raichu decks, where you just can't afford to use those resources six times. There's often times where you can't even afford to use them three times just to win the game, especially in Genesect, so.
Yeah, definitely.
You definitely can afford to take one prize knockouts.
So, pretty solid end of four for Kyle. Laser, Ultra Ball, Juniper, and a Dark Energy. He's going to be able to Ultra Ball away whatever he top decks and that Dark, get out of Pokemon, play Laser and Juniper. Unless, obviously, top decks something that changes that, but...
There's 120 on that Evoltal, and it does set up the non-EX Evoltal to get knocked out from a...
Bench damage, yeah.
And bench damage. Kyle top decks the double colorless.
Ooh, can he knock out that Genesect then?
Yep. He can do 180 with the... Ben sign there, because he can do... He can 180 if he attaches it to the other one, I believe. But I'm not sure. He's only doing 140 right now.
If so he may just be hoping to draw into a Verbank or a
Well, that won't matter because... Oh, his Garbodor up. Okay, yeah. It will matter.
So a Verbank or a Dark Patch will make this a knockout. And he draws neither.
Kyle misses there. That's another thing is that I think, you know, a big part of the reason why Kyle did have the guaranteed knockout.
But it would also set up Ben for a three-price turn, so I think that was just a risk he wasn't willing to take. Exactly. A Muscle Band is also on out, too. He had quite a few. He has two Muscle Bands in play, so I'm assuming he only has one left in the deck, but... I'm just trying to imagine that exchange in advance. If Kyle would have done that and then Ben would have taken his three-price turn, if Kyle were able to return that knockout, though, he would just be in an insanely favorable position. So it's a risk I think I might have taken.
I don't think you can do that if you're Kyle, because the problem is that Ben can just attach to that Genesect on the bench, find the G-Booster, and win the game from there.
Whoa, he would only have two prizes left.
Because he can go, okay. Yeah, exactly, he can just go. I mean, he would have to find something, but that gives him another turn.
Wait, no, but what I was describing was Kyle...
Oh, you're saying if the active Genesect would get knocked out?
Yeah, so Kyle would knock out the active, Ben would knock out Kyle's active with Ben's last Genesect with all his energy on it, and then if Kyle returned that, Ben wouldn't have a board.
Very true.
But that also would be a pretty complicated series of events, and I think Kyle wanted to just play it safe. An Oblivion Wing here doesn't necessarily rule him out of anything.
It would also take a lot, I guess, at that point.
Did he attach a Dark to that Buffalon this turn?
I missed that, I'm not sure. There's the Grass Energy on the Virizion. Ben just getting...
Did he bench the Buffalon this turn?
I honestly do not know. I missed that. And there's the energy switch. Ben gonna take the knockout on that non-EX Evoltal. With the Virizion. And take a prize. Good under four prizes. And all he needs is two more EX knockouts to seal up the game. Kyle promotes the Garbodor. Draws first turn, gets a switch. And for those of you following the tournament, Dustin Zimmerman is currently playing against Brian Zamora.
Correct.
In the top top four, so we... This tournament's just been absolutely star-studded. The top eight is absolutely insane. I mean, Ben is a former world championship qualifier. Kyle's a former national champion, one of the best players of all time. Dustin got fourth place at the 2013 World Championship. So just a lot of talent in this room.
For sure. I think this is one of the most impressive top cuts I've seen in an event this season.
Oh, definitely. I can't really think of a better one.
And also worth noting that Ross Coffin was the only 6-1-1 to miss cut. He got ninth place. So,
I mean, this whole tournament as well. Jason Kozinski was here. Jay Hornung was here. Just some of the best of all time.
We were so close to seeing Ross, Kyle, Dustin, and Sanchez all in the same cut, which would have been pretty incredible. Not to mention Ben, Kevin, and Nick.
Yeah.
That was only seven people. As soon as I remember the eighth, I'll apologize to them. Brian's Warren. There we go.
There's an attachment on the Evotol. There's a laser. Remember, hypnotoxic laser does come into play now that Garbotoxin is active, which is kind of an advantage that the Rizzy Index get normally too, which Ben's doesn't get here, which is going to hurt him. It's usually hypnotoxic laser, just dead cards.
And I feel like Ben. When Virizion was sort of the undisputed best deck in the format during like cities, laser was seeing a lot less play in general. And now Virizion has sort of made somewhat of a resurgence, and I think that the resurgence of laser has led to that. That was a really complicated way of saying things, but basically, Virizion's popularity led to less laser being played. Less laser being played led to less Virizion being played, and now people are playing lasers again, and now Virizion is definitely performing better again.
Kind of saw Virizion take a back seat during States, except for Dustin. Dustin and a few other players played some with the Drift Blimps that we spoke about earlier. But then we saw Michael Chin get second in Seattle last week. We see two copies of Virizion Genesect in the top eight here. I'm not sure about Utah. We are streaming Utah over at twitch.tv/OTBWest. We're going to check that out. But I'm not sure what that type 8 looks like, but we've definitely seen a resurgence of Rizzian. There's a knockout for Ben. Both these players at two prizes left. Kyle promotes a Garbodor. Kyle with a random receiver in his hand. Going to go ahead and find an N. And no G booster in play for Ben. I don't think we've seen it played yet at all. And here, just like last game, we do see Kyle is coming. That Absol is going to do some work. You know, we're not... The Absol might not go anywhere. It doesn't have any energy on it. It might not do anything this turn. But that Absol just is at least going to slow Ben down.
Absolutely.
Slow Ben down a little bit. We have seen the power of that Nani-X throughout Kyle's top eight match, and now maybe into his top four as well.
Absol is another card that I feel like... Underrated might not be the right word, just because... I mean, it's obviously
underplayed,
good,
maybe.
Good, but yeah, underplayed is probably a better way to put it, but I think people might be looking over Absol quite a bit.
And the end of two for Kyle is a Burbank City Gym, I believe,
and a Dark Patch.
And we're past the turn. All Ben needs, I can't see how much damage is on that Evotol, but all right, Ben's just going to take the knockout there. Go up to four cards in hand. Kyle's top deck is a Darkrai.
This game is looking pretty good for Ben. He has one prize left and a G booster in hand. So
I think he had a G booster in hand before the end.
Oh, I did
not
realize
he had it. I don't think he has it. I can't actually tell. I don't think he has it now. Do you have Skyla? Is that a Skyla in hand?
Yeah.
I believe it is.
So, yeah. I think that'll do it.
Yeah, you can, Ben, if that is indeed a card, you can find the G-Booster. G-Booster for the knockout, and yep. Ben Potter takes game one over Kyle Sukovich here in the top four of the Wisconsin Regional Championship. Once again, On the Bubble is brought to you by Top Cut Central. Top Cut Central is giving the winner of this event, I believe, a $250 gift certificate.
I think it's $500.
$500? Not quite sure. Either way, a lot of money on the line. the coolest thing I think the Top Quest Central did, not even being biased, but this tournament, if you finish out the tournament, you played it all out, the winner, sorry, not the winner, the top half of this tournament, so half the people that finish in the tournament, play all their rounds, were given their money back, essentially. They were giving a $25 gift certificate, and the so not quite cash, but you do basically get to rebuy, and very, very cool. I think this is the I don't quote me on this, but I do believe that this event was the only one to have given out extra prizing during the spring regionals, and at very least this much extra prizing. So really shout out to Top Quest Central for that. If you want to support us, support them, support the game, check out topquestcentral.com and buy one of the playmats that you see on your screen. Ben Potter has won game one. We will also update you on the Dustin Zimmerman versus Brian Zamora match. Dustin is playing a Virizion Genesect deck with Raichu, and Brian Brian Zamora is playing a Evil Tall Garbodor deck with no copies of Darkrai. Opening hands, Kyle looks to be without a supporter again. Don't quote me on that, but I do think E&D was without a supporter there. Kyle will be going first, having lost game one, and we are off. The top deck for Kyle is a Bouffalant. Attach the Darkness to the Evil Tall for Kyle. Play the Bouffalant. And pass the turn back to Ben, who draws a Roselia of his own. Gonna go ahead and Ultra Ball. And once again, cannot be overstated, hitting the turn one energy on a Virizion is very important for Ben here. Hitting the turn one energy in general is very important, but turn two Emerald Slash is really what makes this deck work. And Ben is going to go ahead and Ultra Ball a Grass Energy and a Muscle Band away. I assume finding a Virizion EX. Mike Newman is taking a short bathroom break and will be right back, everyone. Also, be sure, if you're watching this live, tune in to the top 8 mates and top 4 now. I'm not quite sure how their schedule is going, of the Utah Regional Championships, where our own Jeremy Jowen is playing in top 8. Over at twitch.tv/OTBWest. There's the Virizion. There's the Roselia. There's an attachment. There's a pass. Evil Tall EX is a draw for Kyle. Still no supporters in hand for Kyle, unfortunately. Attaches to that active. He can Evil Ball for 60. Ben draws, and Ben definitely wants to find a way to get that Genesect out of the discard, out of the active. But when forced to play an end there, so that's really interesting. So this is one of the things that I think makes Evil Tall EX so powerful, is that Ben was kind of forced to play the end there, because if they're just playing a game where neither of them have resources, every energy that Kyle draws is so much better for him than it is for Ben. Because so this is what happens. If Ben passes there, he has no way to retreat his active Genesect EX. He just strips the turn back, and Kyle can continue drawing nothing. He can continue drawing any cards, but he still has two energy in hand, I believe. And every energy he draws just lets him go so much deeper, and just eventually he can attach a DCE and Y Cycle him over the Bouffalant, and kind of just let Ben sit there while Kyle just says, okay, well, you can't beat my Evil Tall EX, so I guess we're just going to play this game all day. And if it lasts another, you know, two, three turns of Ben just passing and passing, Kyle can have two Evil Talls set up, a Bouffalant set up, you know, he can just have everything he'd ever want. And it does look like Kyle got the N off of Ben's N, so he will have a supporter. We've seen Kyle open without a supporter now. Game one of top eight. Game one and two of top eight. And this game, so. And there's the Roserade. Do you know what the Roserade ability is called?
Le Parfum.
Le Parfum?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, right. I remember that. I'm just going to go ahead and get that Sky Arrow Bridge.
Is that what he got with the Roserade?
Yes.
Just wait 5 minutes.
And Let's see, retreat. Unfortunately, Ben's only Genesect EX is the one that's already damaged there on the bench. Took 60 off of that Evil Tall last turn, so.
And unfortunately, it's full art. Ew.
Been playing a mixed match of full arts and non-full arts in this deck. Never want to see that.
Disgusting. Pretty big misplay there, but. He is at least able to Emerald Slash, but yeah, like you said, Emerald Slash into a damaged Genesect is nowhere near ideal.
Not at all.
I don't think Kyle's in a position to take a knockout here.
Do you have to get, like...
I think, yeah, no.
Does he even play Energy Switch, this Kyle?
I don't think so. I highly doubt it. I'd be surprised if we hadn't seen one yet.
Yeah, it's very hard to find the room for Energy Switches and things like that when you're playing Garbodor. Kyle's playing 2-2, I think. So when you have that much room, you can't really play a lot of the fancier stuff. And we've seen Le Parfum really change the game. Both games, I mean, he was the only reason that Ben was able to get the Emerald Slash this turn. Ben, actually, you weren't around, Mike, but Kyle didn't have any supporters in hand for the first two turns, and Ben had to end to get the Genesect active. I was just explaining how the problem is that when both of you have nothing, Evil Tall is so powerful just because every energy is just more damage for Kyle, so Kyle's happy to sit there and just attach Y-Cyclone,
definitely.
And just let Ben...
So there are a whole lot of things that like go into making a card good that people might not consider. That's definitely...
I always say that Evil Tall just provides a lot of free wins because there are a lot of decks that just can't beat an Evil Tall. You know, there are a lot of decks that just... You turn on an Evil Tall, you go first, you get two energy on the first turn, and then they just kind of don't really have anything because you can hit a DC next turn, Muscle Band,
right,
Laser,
and just
kind of go huge with energy, or go huge with damage very, very, very quickly. Ben drops another Virizion on the bench. Yeah, is he without a supporter? Oh, he has a bunch of cards in hand. Okay, I thought he only had the three. There. And Ben, considering his options, he has a Plasma Energy, so he could attach in Red Signal this turn. He may want to try and knock out that Trubbish, but it's very possible that he's just going to attach and knock out that Evil Tall and kind of put Kyle on the back foot immediately. And he's getting a Muscle Band off of Skylar, so it looks like that might be what he's aiming to do.
Something that's kind of awkward about him targeting down Trubbish or trying to keep Garbodor off the field is that, like, in Blastoise, when I'm able to catch her up, his only Trubbish and kill it, like, I know I get two turns of Deluge and it'll be the next turn too, next two turns, and that's great. But in a deck like Virizion Genesect, you kill a Trubbish, and sure, you get your two turns of Red Signal before you can set up another one, but, like, Red Signal is so situational that you might not be able to, like, utilize it in those
definitely,
two turns.
Definitely.
Like, it might not always be...
It's not like a Blastoise ability or anything.
Yeah,
like it's
exactly.
Always
ability where you just need it for a couple turns to get the edge.
Come on, Kyle! Wreck Ben Potter, please!
Being joined in the booth by Papa Jimmy, who appears to be pulling for Kyle.
Papa Jimmy.
I think you thought I said Top Cut Jimmy. Yeah. I definitely said Papa Jimmy.
Our own Jimmy Ballard rooting for Kyle Sugovich here.
Showing plenty of favoritism as the PTO of this event.
Kyle, a Wisconsin native. Ben is from Maryland, I think. I think he lives there now. I don't know.
I know that he went to Salisbury University.
That's a type of steak.
I know,
that's
yeah.
Like college.
So wherever that is, that's where he's from.
It sounds made up. And so we did see Ben actually target down that Garbodor, or that Trubbish, so he's just trying to keep that offline. I think that I do think you are correct that Red Signal, turning off Red Signal is not, or utilizing Red Signal before the Garbodor is up is not really that important. I think that what might be more important for Ben here is the Virizion EX ability. Just being able to, like, not... Just being able to blank Kyle's lasers. Like, Kyle's lasers just do actually nothing as long as the Virizion EX is on the board. And that might be very important for Kyle and there for Ben. And once again, we spoke of the ability of Ben to just kind of take an EX prize and then take another one late game off of a plasma.
I just don't know why I didn't think to just turn the knob down when
right.
I was eating instead. But you can hear me.
And There's a super rod from Ben. Gonna get a bunch of grass energy. That's a problem that these decks had before Professor's Letter was printed, was just running out of grass energy. Me and Mike, as well as Chase Neiman, commentated the Fort Wayne, Indiana Regional Championship, where J.W. Crywall, is that how you pronounce his name?
I think
won.
It's Crywall.
He won that event, and there are a bunch of Raising Genesis decks all around that event, and I would just constantly see that mid-game round of energy, because there was just, I don't know if they played fewer back then, I don't remember what the metagame was like, but I think definitely not having Professor's Letter to be able to search out two at a time was huge. I guess there wasn't Muscle Band back then, so you had more of a reliance on G-Booster maybe was an issue, but you definitely just saw them run out of energy quickly, and we see Ben super running a bunch of energy back in. And Ben really wants to find a second Genesect here.
Absolutely, yeah. He really can't afford to invest too much into that damage run.
He only has that one Genesect, and he definitely is going to need to find one off this end of five. I think he'd be perfectly happy here if he could just find another Genesect and then Emerald Slash right onto it. Set up that Evil Tall for a knockout via Megalo Cannon. But it doesn't look like he has. I see a Sky Arrow Bridge. No Pokemon. Not sure if I see any balls in there. I think he's just going to go ahead and Emerald Slash. Does the Roserade have an attack that does anything relevant? We do see Ben Emerald Slashing onto it.
I know you flip for something. I want to say it's Paralysis, like a 30, and then you flip for Paralysis. I could be wrong. I'm almost positive it's 30. I'm almost positive there's a flip
for Paralysis, or just flip in general. I'm going to look it up. We do see Ben choose to Emerald Slash onto that, so it's possible that he's got a plan. Do you know what set that's from? It's like Dragon Giant. There's a laser that does nothing. And Roserade. 24 cents.
Alright, that's a steal.
Yeah, if you like, buy Roserades now. Buy them while they're low. Ben Potter is going to win a regionals, they're going to skyrocket before nationals. You know what Roserade beats? Pyroar.
Heard that.
Squeeze. Two energy. Grass colorless. 30. Flip a coin if this attack... If heads, this attack does 20 more damage. Until the defending Pokemon is paralyzed. And the defending Pokemon is now paralyzed.
Okay. Called it.
So it does 50... So it's 30 flip if it hits 50 paralyze. Not the worst attack in the world, actually. It's a lot more relevant than I thought it would be.
Kyle, we know he plays a 2 switch. I've seen him discard 1. I'm not sure if he... I guess he could play more than 2. We've seen 2 in most of these games. So paralysis, I suppose, could come into play, but I'd see that as more of a Hail Mary for Ben, not something he really wants to do.
Oh, definitely not. I mean, he didn't hit a second Genesect. And I think in a lot of situations there, you might just Emerald Slash onto that Genesect anyways and just kind of build it up so you can try and G-Booster more, but with 60 damage already...
I think I would have just put 1 on it.
Put 1 on the Genesect?
On the Genesect, yeah. Mm-hmm. Something that's really unfortunate is that you're not able to split up your Emerald Slash. You have to commit to one Pokemon even if you don't get 2 energy.
I actually thought for a long time that you could split it up, which would just make it obviously...
I do know, with Victini EX, you can split your energy. I know that for sure. I can definitely verify that that is the case. But Rizzini EX is clearly inferior. It can't even accelerate lightning or fire energy, so it's worthless for Rayquaza, which makes it a pretty bad card.
What's Victini EX's attack? Wait, don't tell me.
I don't know what's... Which one, dude?
The
Turbo Energizer, Intensifying Burn.
Turbo
They're both pretty good.
Right. Intensifying Burn, wow. Those the old days.
Rest in peace. So Ben ends. I can't even begin to imagine him not getting another Genesect here. I think that would be way too much for him to come back from if he's not able to Emerald Slash to another Genesect or G-Booster or just do something, but he is definitely in pretty dire straits at the moment.
I think if he can... one of the issues here for Ben is that if he does get another Genesect now, it might be a little bit too late. He'll have to Emerald Slash onto it, And then that Verizian is going to get knocked out, leaving Kyle with two prizes and leaving Kyle only needing one more EX knockout to seal up the game.
This is a game I feel like I might concede if I were Ben, but also it's not a matchup that I'm terribly familiar with. Is he putting a third energy on his own? Okay.
I don't think you can see just because there's so much time left.
Is there?
I mean, there's 75 minutes, right? And there's no way that game one took more than...
That's fair.
I don't know, 15, so...
It should be plenty. I guess, yeah, I forget that 75 is plenty of time for three full games. I'm conditioned to 50 minutes. Yeah, concession is stupid. I should have said that. Right, I'm so embarrassed. Oh, my God.
Looks like Ben misses the paralysis flip.
Shucks.
Doing 30 damage to that Evil Tall EX.
Dang.
Dang.
That does set it up to die to two muscle-banded Emerald Slashes.
That's true.
Thank God.
I mean, for what it's worth, if he would have gotten the paralysis there, that would have been really good for him.
Like,
if Ben would have just been able to stall a turn there, like... Because Kyle plays Switch, yes?
Yeah.
He plays two.
We've seen two. There could be a third.
Video game regionals going on today as well.
Freaks everywhere.
VGC. Apparently he's a former world champion for the VGC.
It's pretty cool.
I guess.
Hire me, Pokemon.
And see seven cards. For Ben, there's the second Genesect. Look how thin Ben's deck is.
Jeez.
Going down, all the finding is.
He must just play three and have one prize.
Yeah, that's what I would assume. I wonder if he's making, like, what's... Do you know Dustin's Ultra and Level Ball count in his Raichu deck?
I want to say 3-1.
Okay.
I know that...
I wonder if Ben cut any amount of Ultra Balls for Level Balls.
They had all been playing Roserade up until... Friday night, and they swapped out the 2-2 Roserade for a 2-2 Raichu and changed nothing else about the list.
They being Dustin Zimmerman.
Yeah,
and
Dustin and Jacob Olinger.
Okay. Tyler Moore also played that deck in the Utah Regional Championship yesterday and did very poorly, unfortunately.
It happens.
But Dustin making it up. There's a Plasma Energy.
So if he does decide to go after that Trubbish, he will get rid of Garbodor for good, but I think he senses that he's too far behind to prioritize that, so he's going to go for an EX.
Yeah, I think he can just kind of take the very simple knockout here, very easy knockout, I should say, that Evil Tall has 100 on it, it looks like, 120. Not quite sure, but either way, if it has 120 on it, actually, he can Emerald Slash onto it, knock it out, which would be huge. Like, I apologize, I'm not actually sure.
I think it's 100. That looks like two fives.
Yeah, he is promoting the Genesect Megalo Cannon for the knockout. 20 onto
and that's
that.
That's the damage Genesect, correct?
That is the not damage Genesect. Or, sorry, yes, that is the damage Genesect.
So,
it's the full
have we
one.
Seen any energy switch out of Ben yet?
No, I don't think so.
Because energy switch is going to be really big here for him to be able to Emerald Slash, or to be able to G-Booster, which I think he's going to have to do to stay in this game. Assuming we see a return knockout from Kyle onto that damage Genesect. Well, wait, is that only three on that Genesect? There's been three this whole time?
No.
Because that's not that bad.
I believe it had six. Maybe that one had been knocked out. I apologize.
Hire me, TPCI. So either way, Kyle shouldn't have too hard of a time knocking out that Genesect, assuming he gets Garbotoxin up this turn and is able to use his lasers. There's no Verbink in play, so maybe it is too tall of an order, but... I think that might kind of set the tone for the rest of the game, whether or not Kyle's able to knock out this Genesect.
Killer Toxin, not quite online yet. Still needs a tool on that Garbodor. But he does have a bicycle in hand. And go ahead and draw him three cards.
Two Junipers, a DCE, and an N.
Adding himself on the three here. I think it's interesting to see when these players choose to play Ns there, because like Kyle's deck is very, very thin. But I think he's fine just playing an N because he feels like he's ahead. And so he feels like that him going down to three cards is just so much, doesn't matter as much as Ben going to the three. Like, Ben still needs to kind of dig for things, and so does Kyle, mind you. But Kyle's fine just Y-Cycloning this turn, Evil Balling if you can get the knockout. 20, 40, 60, 140.
And there's already 30 on it, so that is a knockout.
Yep. And Kyle, one prize,
which is pretty scary.
Ben promoting the Sigilyph, and can't quite see what's in his hand. I see an energy.
If Ben doesn't play energy switch, I really don't like his odds here.
And there's the grass onto the Genesect. See a plasma energy and an enhanced hammer.
That's it?
Yep. There's an enhanced hammer and the DCE on the Bouffalant. There's one other card too, sorry. It looks like it's a Pokemon of some sort. And Ben passes the turn back. So Kyle doesn't play away. He doesn't play a catcher effect, right? He does not play away to knock out that Vizian on the bench. But the problem is that Kyle is now loading up two attackers. He has two Evil Talls. Ben does not have access to Red Signal at the moment.
Kyle can just Evil Ball that, or Y-Cyclone that DCE back to the bench boy, and since he only has one prize left, just set it up to knock out anything that Ben has active.
True indeed. And does Ben not play Tool Scrapper?
We haven't seen one yet.
Yes, I saw some Kyle and Ben are pretty close, and I assume they know which other they're playing as well. So I think Kyle would be pretty comfortable doing that if Ben, if he knew Ben didn't play Tool Scrapper, because then we wouldn't have access to Scrapper, Red Signal, knock out your big Evil Tall. Because like I said, I think, go on.
No, I was just going to point out that the Virizion's asleep, and that could just...
Oh, wow, the Virizion's asleep. Yeah, that could.
If the Virizion stays asleep coming back into Kyle's turn, it should not be very difficult for him to knock it out.
Definitely. And I also think that it's very... The conservative play for Kyle, I just think, is to load up two Evil Talls and just kind of sit behind two of them and say, if something bad happens to one, it doesn't matter because I have this other one just fully built up. And, like, the game can play for as many turns as we'd like. You know what I mean? I don't care.
We are going to see this game come down to a coin flip. Not necessarily heads I win, tails you lose, but if Ben flips tails on this sleep check, that will be the game. He's going to take 30 going in his turn, 30 coming out, and then that Veltal on the bench is ready to do 110 on a moment's notice. So I think Kyle might be going with the strategy I suggested of just setting up the Veltal to kill anything to take that one prize.
Definitely.
He doesn't Y-Cyclone, so maybe not.
Well, he still has a bunch of energy on the other guy,
right? So yeah, maybe that's just going to be enough. But if Ben flips tails here, that is absolutely the game. There's nothing he'll be able to do.
And there's heads, and the draw step is an enhanced hammer, it looks like. So there's a Genesect. There's the enhanced hammer on the DCE on the active Evil Tall,
which could prevent him from retreating.
There's the attack, retreat, send up my Genesect, and now Ben is fully just in stall mode. But it might not work now. If Kyle has a double colorless, it's game, right? Because he can catch DCE to the benched Evil Tall. 140 plus the laser damage will be 170?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He just needs an energy. He doesn't need it. It can be the dark. 20
energy. Yeah, plus he just needs any energy to win here.
Oh, no, because he can't retreat. Yeah, Volta has a 2 retreat cost. He needs a float zone and an energy.
Oh, jeez. Well.
He's judging.
He's also drawing a pretty good portion of his deck, so if he has those cards in there, he should get them.
Yeah.
I'm just not sure if he does. So he's not quite yet. Retreat.
I mean, he's still in such a good position. Like, whenever you see players just choosing to retreat around and make you take knockouts like that, or make you deal damage like this, like, you just, you're definitely in the driver's seat. And it'll take a lot for Kyle to lose here, I believe.
Absolutely.
Once again.
Go on. Never mind. Okay, sorry. Bouffalant is... Oh, no, he's got it. He just retreats with the DCE and plays that Dark Patch. We neglected the Dark Patch.
Oh, we drew a Dark Patch?
Yeah.
Okay. Kyle doing some last-minute counting. Retreating, and that is the knockout and the game. Kyle Sukovic ties this matchup 1-1 versus Ben Potter. Once again, Dustin Zimmerman is playing against Brian... Brian Zamora in the semifinals. Dustin Zimmerman, of course, the 2013 World Championship semifinalist. Did you save it? Did you save it as a...
No, I didn't.
Okay.
I'm on it. So, we've seen good games from both players, good showings, that is. Who do you, who's your favorite in Game 3?
I think Ben getting to go first is going to be pretty big here. But I really don't know. It seems like Ben is kind of, each game, even the one that he won, he has kind of floundered around a bit. He definitely has not hit that just turn 2 Emerald, slash a bunch of energy, do it again on turn 3, take a prize, G-Booster, G-Booster, G-Booster. Like, he hasn't hit that just what he wants out of it. And I don't know if that's just luck or if the running... The interesting thing to me is Roserade. I think Roserade's very, very interesting, but I also think that it's very similar, or it can be very similar to... Electrode and Blastoise, where it does provide more consistency, but you have to cut cards to fit it in. I don't actually know. I haven't played Risen in a long time. I'm not sure how that works out. I don't know Ben's list at all. But I do know that sometimes when you put those kind of consistency cards in, you can cut other things that you need. So I do wonder if Ben maybe is struggling a little bit. Because if he can't set up the Roserade, especially versus a Garbodor deck, maybe he just can't kind of execute his game plan how he wants to. Obviously, it's been fine for him here. He's in the top four of the most competitive regionals in the country. But I'm kind of pulling for Ben here. I think that going first will provide him a big advantage. How about you?
I think that's a really fair assessment. I feel like G-Booster has not really come into play here, and I think Ben's lack of energy switch is why G-Booster hasn't been as much of a force, and I think G-Booster is this deck's best bet against a deck like Kyle's, and without being able to totally utilize it, that gives Kyle the edge, in my opinion.
Definitely. We did see G-Booster come into play in Game 1, but that was, just, again, it was after Ben had drawn dead for a few turns, hit a Skyla, and then hit a G-Booster, so it's definitely anyone's game. It'll be interesting to see. It doesn't look like Kyle has a supporter in his hand. Again, I could be wrong, but it looks like he has a bicycle and a
homeboy cannot catch
energy.
A break. A dowsing machine that's got a sting. Could have been a computer search, but...
Yeah, draws the dowsing. But yeah, no supporters, just...
Is he going to be able to play his hand down enough to bike?
No, because you can't dowsing machine for nothing, right?
Correct.
So he can't, like...
Yeah.
Play anything. There's a muscle band.
Passes.
And Ben choosing to Skylon turn 1 for a Professor Sycamore, playing Ultra Ball now, getting a Genesect. If he has a second energy in hand, it's going to be very good for him. If not, he has the second.
He totally does. He just played a Skyla, didn't he?
No. He played Skyla last turn. He played
Ultra Ball away a Skyla.
Yeah, Ultra Ball away the Skyla now.
Got it.
I mean, even if he doesn't have it in hand, he's going to choose for Sycamore for it.
I was saying he wouldn't have played the Skyla if he didn't have energy, but obviously that probably went without saying. I'm not looking to insult anyone's intelligence here.
There's the Professor Sycamore. There's a second.
Plasma energy, which isn't ideal, but it'll do it.
It'll do.
Yeah. And also keeping in mind, if Kyle draws nothing here, that'll just be the game.
Dustin Zimmerman has advanced to the finals of the Wisconsin Regional Championship. Did Kyle already draw first turn? No, I think he's searching. Okay, Ben's searching.
Ben's still going. So we're guaranteed in the finals. We're going to see Rizzy,
arguably two of the best players in the game, in Kyle and Dustin, or my preference in all Hovercat finals, with Ben taking
there's
Dustin,
the top deck.
So.
It's a float stone. I don't think that Kyle has outs. Because
so Ben just needs the Roserade for G-Booster and advance.
So he already has G-Booster in hand, I think.
Oh, crap. Yeah, he's done. That sucks.
Yeah, there's energy attachment. And Kyle passes the turn. Ben draws the Roserade off the top. And
hate to see it end like this.
Can find the third energy. I believe he has a G-Booster in hand.
He has to. He would have. There's no way he would.
I think he has a Muscle Band in hand as well. So many. So, yeah, there's a Muscle Band, and that's
His time.
Gonna be game.
He's giving Kyle the choice.
Shows him the two tools. Ben Potter advances to the finals of the Madison, Wisconsin Regional Championships.
Finals.
We'll be right back.